My last video started like this. You and your family are going broke right now, and you don't even know it. And this is the truth. Since this video opened a debate on the subject, I feel a need to elaborate on it to make it a little bit easier to understand. The important thing to understand is that a little inflation is not the end of the world, and it may be necessary to allow the economy to grow. But what is not good, however, is the inflation that's going on today. In my last video, I mentioned a gold standard, and this was to emphasize that it would keep the Federal Reserve from circulating too much money and devaluing the currency that you already have. It's all about the percentage of money you have versus the amount of currency in circulation. To make the math simple, let's say there's a total of $10 million in circulation and you have $1 million. This means you have 10% of the total currency. Now imagine if the Federal Reserve decided to issue another $10 million and put that in circulation as well, for a new total of $20 million, but you didn't get any of the new money to offset the imbalance. So you just went from having 10% down to 5% of the total currency in circulation. And even though you didn't spend a dime of your money, the value of the currency you saved just got cut in half. So when the new money is issued by the Federal Reserve and it gets put in circulation, the currency you hold loses value because the prices will inflate to adjust to the new amount of total currency in circulation. So let's look at the current inflation this way. Say you're a teenager saving for college. You started saving at the beginning of 2004, and to make it simple, we'll start the savings of $2,000 every January 1st since 2004. So in January 2004, 5, 6, and 7, you save $2,000 at the beginning of each year. So at the end of 4 years, you've amassed $8,000 total towards your college education. Unfortunately, over the past 4 years, we've been in an endless war on terror, and it's caused our government to spend more money than ever before. And it's decreased the value of the dollars that you set aside for college. Since many look to gold as a barometer for the dollar and its current value, let's see what happened if you put your money into gold on January 2004, 5, 6, and 7 and see what it would be worth today. The price of gold in January 2004 was $410 an ounce, and you'd be able to buy 4.88 ounces. In January 2005, it was $422 an ounce, you'd be able to buy 4.73 ounces. In January 2006, it was $560 an ounce, you'd be able to buy 3.57 ounces. And in January 2007, it was $630 an ounce, and you'd be able to buy 3.17 ounces. So this gives you a total amount of 15.57 ounces of gold in your possession. And that 15.5 ounces of gold would now be valued at $14,484 at the current spot price of $930 per ounce. So the inflation over the last 4 years has been a total of $6,484. So the buying power for that original $8,000 you saved has been reduced to roughly $4,480, almost half. This is destroying your ability to save money, causing you to lose a good portion of your savings without even spending it. So in essence, it's punishing you for trying to save money for a future investment and endorses spending today while your dollar is worth more, and increasing the total debt accumulated by Americans. Now keep in mind, you're not really making money by putting your cash into gold and silver. You're only hedging against inflation or maintaining the value of the money you've just saved.